Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture. This lecture will cover the fundamentals of structural geology, which is from unit 4 of engineering geology and remote sensing subject CE405. जैसा कि हम सब जानते हैं कि अर्थ क्रस्ट जो है वो डिवाइडेड होती है इनटू नंबर ऑफ टेक्टोनिक प्लेट्स and these plates are in continuous motion. This movement causes deformation on the surface of the earth and leads to formation of various structural features like folds, faults, unconformities, etc. In sab structures ki study hum karte hain structural geology subject mein. So structural geology ko hum define kaise karenge? It is the study of three-dimensional distribution of rocks with respect to their deformational history. It deals with the study of morphology, classification, mechanism and causes of development of different types of structures in rocks. Structure geology में हम कुछ basic terms use करते हैं and some common terms are outcrop, strike and depth. First term है outcrop. जो solid rocks होती हैं वो earth surface पर सब जगह exposed नहीं होती हैं because these are mostly covered with the thick or thin layer of soil. बट कुछ एरियाज होते हैं जैसे कि माउंटेनियस एंड सब माउंटेनियस ट्रैक्स या फिर शेलो प्लेन्स जहाँ पर हम इजीली रॉक एक्सपोजर देख सकते हैं. तो जहाँ पर रॉक सरफेस पर एक्सपोज होती है वो कहलाते हैं आउटक्रॉप. तो आउटक्रॉप इज सिंपली डिफाइंड एज एनी जियोलॉजिकल फॉर्मेशन एक्सपोज ऑन द सरफेस इज कॉल्ड एन आउटक्रॉप. नेक्स्ट टर्म है आपकी स्ट्राइक. जब हम फील्ड में रॉक्स की स्टडी करते हैं तो हम उसके कुछ एटीट्यूड मेजर करते हैं जो हमें ये इन्फॉर्मेशन प्रोवाइड करते हैं कि रॉक सरफेस पे कैसे एक्सपोज हो रखी है. मीन्स उसके जो रॉक बैड्स हैं उनका डिपॉजिशन कैसे हो रखा है, वो हॉरिजॉन्टली डिपॉजिटेड हैं या टिल्टेड हैं. अगर टिल्टेड हैं तो उनका एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन क्या है. तो दो बेसिक टर्म्स हम यूज करते हैं टू मेजर द एटीट्यूड ऑफ रॉक्स इन फील्ड, दिस आर स्ट्राइक एंड डिप. स्ट्राइक रेफर्स टू द डायरेक्शन इन विच जियोलॉजिकल स्ट्रक्चर इज प्रेजेंट. Strike direction is the geographic direction formed by intersection of horizontal plane with the bedding plane of a layer of rock. Means strike जो होती है वो direction होती है एक line का जो बनती है by the intersection of bedding plane and horizontal plane. जैसे कि हम इस diagram में देख सकते हैं strike जो है वो represent की गई by a black solid line and this line is formed by the intersection of horizontal plane and bedding plane of layered rock. Another term is dip. Dip जो है rock bed का inclination होता है. Rock bed किस angle पर tilt हो रहा है वह dip कहलाता है. Dip को हम measure करते हैं with respect to horizontal plane. So dip is defined as the maximum angle of inclination of a layer of rock with the horizontal. In structural geology, dip is expressed both as direction and amount. The dip direction is the direction along which inclination of bedding plane occurs, while the amount of dip is the angle of inclination which a bedding plane makes with the horizontal plane. स्लाइड में हम डायग्राम देख रहे हैं उसमें हम एक हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन देख सकते हैं. बैडिंग प्लेन इज ऑल्सो देयर विच इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई डिफरेंट कलर्स, ग्रे एंड ऑरेंज कलर. लाइन ऑफ स्ट्राइक इज देयर विच इज फॉर्म बाय द इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन एंड बैडिंग प्लेन. डिप एंगल इज द एंगल बिटवीन द हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन एंड बैडिंग प्लेन. Dip varies from 0 to 90 degree. Dip of horizontal bed is 0 degree while that of vertical bed is 90 degree. Dip and strike are at right angle to each other. There are two types of dip, true dip and apparent dip. When the dip of layer is measured in a direction that is essentially at right angles to the strike of that particular layer, it is called true dip. While when the dip of layer is measured in any other direction which is not at right angle to its strike direction, it is called an apparent dip. As clear from this diagram, number 1 represents strike, 2 is true dip which is at right angle to the strike, while 3 is apparent dip which is at some other angle other than right angle to the strike. So these are some basic terminologies which are used in structural geology. Now we will discuss about folds, which are one of the most common geological structure found in the rocks. This topic will cover the following points which we are going to discuss. What are folds, parts of folds, classification of folds and causes of folding. So what are folds? Folds are undulations or bands or curvatures shown by rock beds or layers. अब ये folds develop कैसे होते हैं? Folds are developed in the rocks of the crust as a result of stresses to which these rocks have been subjected from time to time in the past history of the earth. When a set of horizontal layers are subjected to compressive stress, they bend either upward or downward. As shown in this diagram, these are horizontal strata of the earth crust before folding. When this strata is subjected to compressive stress, the crust shortens and forms folds. Folds are mostly developed due to the compressive stresses applied to the layer of the rocks. The process of formation of folds in the rocks are called folding. Parts of folds. A number of terms are used to describe the shape of folds. Some of the most common terms used are as follows. Limbs. These are the sloping sides or flanks of fold. These are limbs of fold. Hinge. It is the area of maximum curvature. This portion, where one limb ends and other limb starts. This is also known as hinge point. Next term is hinge line. When strata occurs in a sequence and where all hinge points are joined together, they form a line and this line is known as hinge line. Axial plane. Axial plane is the imaginary plane or surface that divides the fold symmetrically into two equal halves. This is the axial plane which divides the folds into two equal halves. Crest and trough. Folds may be up-arched or down-arched. So crest is the highest point in the up-arched fold, while trough is the lowest point in the down-arched fold. Axis of fold. Axis is a line drawn parallel to the hinge line of a fold. This is the fold axis, which is parallel to the hinge line. Or in other words, it is defined as line of intersection between axial plane and the fold. This plane is known as axial plane and this is the folded layer. So fold axis is formed by the intersection between axial plane and the fold. Plunge of fold. Fold axis may be vertical, inclined or horizontal. If the fold axis is horizontal, it has a zero plunge and such type of folds are known as non-plunging folds. But when fold axis is inclined as shown in this diagram, it makes an angle with the horizontal plane and this angle is known as plunge of fold. So plunge is the angle of inclination of fold axis with the horizontal as measured in a vertical plane. Folds show a great variety of forms. Some may be quite simple, but others may be highly complex and complicated in their geometry and morphology. In fact, in most cases, folds may be simple or complex modification of two basic types of folds, anticline and syncline. Anticline is an upfold where limbs dip away from the axis of fold on either side, while syncline is a downfold where the limbs dip towards the axis of fold on either side. If this is an fold axis, then in anticline, the anticline folds are upfold, means anticline folds होते हैं वो convex होते हैं upward and their limbs dip away from the axis of fold. While synclines are convex downward and their limbs dip towards the fold axis on either side. Folds are classified on number of parameters. First parameter is on the basis of position of axial plane. On this basis, folds are classified into two categories. First is symmetrical folds. These folds are also known as normal or upright folds. In such fold, the axial plane is essentially vertical. As shown in this diagram, this is the axial plane. Axial plane is vertical and the limbs are equal in length. These two limbs are of equal length and dip equally in opposite direction. Means if यहाँ पर अगर 45 डिग्री एंगल है तो दिस एंगल इज ऑल्सो 45 डिग्री. मीन्स लिम्स डिप इक्वली इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. दिस टाइप ऑफ फोल्ड्स मे बी एंटीक्लाइन और सिंक्लाइन. अनदर फोल्ड इज एसिमेट्रिकल फोल्ड. इन एसिमेट्रिकल फोल्ड एक्सियल प्लेन इज इंक्लाइंड. दिस इज एक्सियल प्लेन एंड दिस इज इंक्लाइंड एंड लिम्स आर अनइक्वल इन लेंथ. शोन इन दिस डायग्राम दिस लिम्ब इज लॉन्गर देन this limb and this limbs dip unequally on either side from the hinge line. If this is of 90 degree, then this angle is of 40 degree. Means these two angles are not equal. This type of folds are also may be anticline or syncline. Third type of fold is isoclinal fold. These are group of folds in which axial planes are essentially parallel. जैसे कि हम इस डायग्राम में देख रहे हैं एक्सियल प्लेन क्या है, सब पैरेलल हैं दूसरों के एंड दीज आर ग्रुप ऑफ फोल्ड्स एंड द लिम्ब्स डिप एट इक्वल अमाउंट्स. दे आर मेड अप ऑफ सीरीज ऑफ एंटीक्लाइन एंड सिंक्लाइन. दीज आर कॉल्ड आइसोक्लाइनल फोल्ड्स. ओवरटर्न फोल्ड्स आर फोल्ड्स विद इंक्लाइंड एक्सियल प्लेन. मे बी एक्सियल प्लेन क्या रहता है, इंक्लाइंड रहता है. In which both the limbs are dipping essentially in the same general direction. Limbs जो होते हैं वो एक ही direction में dip करते हैं. But overturned fold में एक limb जो है वो normal position पे रहता है, but दूसरा limb जो होता है वो ज़्यादा turn हो जाता है. As shown in this diagram, therefore it is known as overturned fold. Overfolding indicates severe degree of folding. Next fold is recumbent fold. In recumbent fold, limbs are horizontal due to intense folding. Axial plane is also almost horizontal. In such folds, one limb comes to lie exactly under the other limb. And the lower limb is known as inverted limb, while the upper limb is known as reversed limb. Second classification is on the basis of degree of compression. On the basis of degree of compression, folds are classified into open folds and closed folds. In open folds, thickness of the bed is uniform throughout the fold. जैसे कि हम डायग्राम में देख रहे हैं, जो thickness है folded layer के बीच की, वो सब जगह क्या है, uniform है. And in closed folds, beds are thinner in limb portion. Limbs में अगर हम देखें तो thickness क्या है, कम है, is compared to the axial region या crest. वहाँ पे थिकनेस ज्यादा है, तो क्रेस्ट पे थिकनेस ज्यादा है एंड ट्रफ में क्या है, क्रेस्ट एंड ट्रफ में थिकनेस ज्यादा है. और जो लिम पोर्शन है वहाँ पे थिकनेस जो है बेड की वो कम है. थर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बिहेवियर विद डेप्थ एंड ऑन दिस बेसिस फोल्ड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू concentric or parallel folds and similar folds. What are concentric folds? In concentric fold, thickness of involved layer remain uniform and constant even after folding. जो thickness रहती है folded layer की वो क्या रहती है, constant रहती है, constant and uniform रहती है even after folding. But खाली क्या होता है, सिर्फ shape change होता है. As shown in this diagram, anticline becomes sharper with depth and syncline becomes sharper up. ये एंटीक्लाइन पोर्शन है फोल्ड का विच बिकम शार्पर विद डेप्थ, व्हाइल द सिंक्लाइन, दिस इज सिंक्लाइन एंड इट बिकम्स शार्पर अपवर्ड्स. सिमिलर फोल्ड एक्सियल रीजन आर थिकर देन द लिम्स. दैट इज थिकनेस चेंजेस विद डेप्थ बट द शेप रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड. देन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ पोजिशन ऑफ एक्सिस फोल्ड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू प्लंजिंग फोल्ड एंड नॉन प्लंजिंग फोल्ड. In plunging fold, fold axis is not horizontal, but it makes an angle with the horizontal, and this angle is known as plunge, and the folds are known as plunging folds. In non plunging fold, fold axis is essentially horizontal and the fold has 0 degree plunge and therefore known as non plunging folds. Then on the basis of profile of fold surface, folds are classified into chevron folds and conjugate folds or box folds. Chevron folds have sharp hinge points and straight planar limbs. Means limbs are straight and parallel, while hinge portion make a peak like structure, sharp peak like structure. Conjugate folds are composite folds with two hinges, as shown in this diagram. There are two hinges, this portion and this portion is a hinge portion, and three planar limbs. One limb is this, second one is this, and third one is this, in which central limb is flattened and form a box-like structure, and therefore it is known as box fold. Tensis classification is on the basis of mode of occurrence. On this basis, folds are classified into anticlinorium and synclinorium. Anticlinorium and synclinorium are large size folds running over several thousand hundred kilometers in length and width. In anticlinorium, the strata as a whole have been upharved and consist of a number of small scale folds of various types. Means anticlinorium mein ek jo strata jo hote hain wo anticline shape ke hote hain and consist of smaller number of secondary folds. Synclinorium strata as a whole have been downarched with numerous small scale folds. So these are the classification of folds. Next, causes of folding. Folds are developed both due to tectonic and non-tectonic reasons. But most commonly folds are developed due to lateral compression and shear forces, as shown in this diagram. These are horizontal layer, but due to compressive stresses they changes into folds. Igneous intrusion of viscous magma such as lagolith and lopolith are also contribute to folding. This diagram shows the igneous intrusion and here the folds are developed into the overlying sediment. Non-tectonic causes like landslides, creeping, differential compressions, isostatic settings and glaciations are also responsible for the formation of folds. So that's how we understand about the folds, one of the most common geological structures found in the rocks. Thank you very much. Stay tuned and have a great day.